रेडियो नेक्स्ट चैप्टर बेटा, सेंटर ऑफ मास एंड कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम। And the conservation of your linear momentum. Okay, so we will be studying about your complete center of mass and also conservation of your linear momentum. In what cases the momentum is said to be conserved? Okay, let's see here. Center of mass of a body need not be always at the center, beta. It may also be outside, like between sun and earth. The center of mass lies will between somewhere line joining between them, and mass is also not necessary. Like say for ring, if I am talking about, even though ring is a circular and we doesn't have the any mass at the center of mass for that one will lie at the center. And if for body to have a center of mass, masses need not compulsorily be required. And it is also not a compulsory rule that a center of mass should lie only at the center of a body. It may also lie at the outside. It may also lie at the outside part. The best example is the center of mass between Earth and Sun. It will lie between the line joining between them. Somewhere in between them, there will be the center of mass part of equation. Okay, na?
Yes.
Chalo. If I am talking about like this, beta. If you have got two particles, like say for example, a mass of your M1. Okay, and another one is somewhere here. This is a mass of your M2. Both of them are separated by distance of, say, for example, r. Okay, center of mass of this one will lie somewhere outside. Somewhere outside, like say, somewhere the mass is part of relation. Somewhere at this given condition or anywhere, this is your center of mass. COM, center of mass. That means if this is your r1. So obviously this distance will be equal r2. So this r1 plus r2 will be equal to r. Okay, na beta? So what is the given condition here? R is equals to distance between m1 and m2. R1 is equals to distance from M1. Distance from your M1. And R2 is equals to distance from your M2. Isn't it? About this center of mass, beta, you need to remember, mass is inversely proportional to your R. About the center of mass, mass is inversely proportional to your R. And a moment is considered to be given condition. About the center of mass, I can write here. About center of mass, M1 R1 will be equal to your M2 R2 because mass is inversely proportional to your R. Okay, mass is inversely proportional to R. That means mass moment of the particle about the center of mass should always be equal to zero. And the summation of all the particles is known. N number of particles unnai anko mth particle irth particle must be equal to zero, must be equal to your zero. Ante enti mass moment of particles, mass moment of particles about center of mass is zero. So it is m inversely proportional to r kabatti proportional constant this is kunte will get some constant beta. So m into r will be equal to how much for me? M into r will be equal to your constant. That is the reason for two particles m1 r1 is equals to your m2 r2. Or else I can write this one as m1 r1 is equals to your m2. Can I write the value of r2 in terms of r1 beta?
Yes sir.
R2 gana this is kunte r minus of your r1. R minus of your r1. So if I simplify this one, M1 R1 is equals to your m2 into your r minus m2 into your r1, isn't it? So all the r1 terms I'll take one side. So if I'm taking this one here, and this will be here right now. So this minus will become here plus. So it is m1 plus of your m2 into, this will become for me r1. You bring this one here. So that will be equal to your m2 into your r. Okay. So I can write that distance from m1, distance from m1, r1 will be equal to your how much? Distance of center of mass from m1. And r1 is equals to, see, r1 is equals to m2 into r. This one is m2 into r divided by your m1 plus of your m2. Isn't it, Peter?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So r1 is equal to how much for me? And r1 is equals to your m2 into your r divided by m1 plus m2. In the same way, if I'm talking about distance of center of mass from m2. From m2. So I can write this one as m2 into r2 is equals to. I can write this one as of your m into your, this one is r minus of your r2. Previously, yes. R2 I took it as of your R minus of your R1. Now, here it is R1 only. Correct reaction?
Yes, sir.
M2 into your R2. Chalo, fine. So, this one is M2 into your R2 is equals to M into R. You multiply this one minus of M into your R2. This minus of R2 you take here right now. This will become for me again. This one is what? M1, na? This one is M1. This one is also M1. So it is M2 into your M2 plus of your M1 into your R2 is equals to. This one is your M1 into R. That means R2 will be equal to your M1 into R divided by M1 plus of your M2. So this is the distance of your center of mass from your M2. So these are two important, very, very important formulas between center of mass. What is the distance of the center of mass from the first particle? And what is the distance of the center of mass from the second particle? It is based upon what law, meter? Mass moment. Mass moment means the product of mass into distance of the center of mass must be equal to zero. Sum of all the particles what you are taking, that must be equal to zero. R m into r must be equal to your constant. Okay? Na?
Yes. Yes.
We'll try to do one problem on this one. Let's see one example. In carbon dioxide molecule, in CO molecule, distance between the center of atom, the distance between centers of atom is 3.5 angstroms. Then find the distance of center of mass from O. Okay, so in carbon dioxide molecule, and a CO molecule. So in the CO molecule, distance between the center of the atoms is, that means this is your carbon and this one is your oxygen. Oxygen and this one is carbon. The distance between them is given as R. R is equal to how much, beta? 3.5. R 3.6 you can take easy calculation. 3.6 into 1 angstrom is how much? 10 to the power of minus 10 meters. Okay, na?
Excellent.
Center of mass is somewhere in between them. Like here it is your center of mass, COM. So this one is R1, this one is your R2. So what is asking? Then find the distance of center of mass from your O, ante oxygen. Oxygen nunchi center of mass enta?
R2.
R2. So we need to calculate the value of your R2. So from M2, this one is your M2, this one is your M1. So from M2, from your M2, R2 will be equal to your, how much? M1 into R divided by M1 plus of your M. M1 value is how much for me, boss?
Mass of carbon.
Mass of carbon. 12.
Yes.
Into R. R value is how much? 3.6 into 10 to the power of minus 10 divided by. This one is 12 plus. Idanta. 16. Oxygen.
Yes, sir.
How much? 28. Then,
yes.
So it is 12 into 3.6 into 10 to the power of minus 10 divided by 28. Okay. And the sun.
Four threes are 3 4. Sorry, you can do 3 with 3 in count.
Yes. This will become for me. Is 5 way better? Yes. Better. 5 will be better.
Yes.
I'll take this on 5.
One's
so this will be 7 ones are. 7.5,
yes.
Isn't it? So how much it is? 3 into 0.5 and 1.5. Yes, sir. Thanks. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Sure. So like this, we'll be getting the questions on this one. But roughly, I have given you one questions. We'll do the practice of the questions in the next sessions, okay? So this was about your first part of your center of mass, where you need to remember how do you calculate the center of mass from the each particle. Okay.
Yes.
Sure. Next one, tell them. Next one is position of center of mass in a plane. In a plane and space. Okay. Position of center of mass in a plane and as well as of your space. Let's say if I take the coordinates like this. This one is your y-axis. And this one is your x-axis. Okay. And here is somewhere the particle on come. And here there is another particle. Okay. So this one is x1, comma 0. This one is x2, comma 0. Okay. And the center of mass is in between them somewhere here. Here there is center of mass. COM. That means this is your XEM, comma 0. X axis together, y axis zero.
Yes.
So distance is right now from here to here. This is the position of center of mass from where beta? From origin. Okay, now? And the distance between these two particles is either chassis R1, either chassis R2. Then,
yes, sir.
So that is the given condition. So about center of mass, if I'm writing about center of mass, we know the relation M1 R1 is always equals to M2 into your R2. So yes. This one is M1 into. So what is the value of R1? This XEM, this is your XEM minus of your X1. Together, XEM minus of your X1. And the particle is right now. Is the X1 gather?
Yes, sir.
This one is X1.
Okay, yes, sir. X1 and this one is X2.
XEM minus X1 will give me what? R1. And from here to here, this will be equal to your X2.
Okay, yes.
So that is equals to your M2 into R2 will become how much, beta? R2 will be equal to your X2 minus this one.
Yes, so this
X2 minus of your XCOM. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
I just multiply this one right now. So this will become for me your M1 into your XCM. Then next one is minus M1 into your X1 is equals to M2 into your X2 minus M2 into your XCOM. Okay, now all XCOM you take on one side, beta, isn't it? So I can write this of your M1 into XCM plus that's of your M2 into your XCM is equals to M1 X1 plus of your M2 into your X2. So XCOM ento avutundi manam x coordinate of the center of mass will be equal to your M1 X1 plus of your M2 X2 divided by this one is your M1 plus of your M2. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
So that is the center of mass for the given condition. And the particles are lying in your X coordinate. And then YCM will be equal to how much, beta? YCM will be equal to how much for me? Zero. YCM is equal to
because zero. Nothing is there. So
along Y axis and along Z axis, the center of mass will be equal to zero. In a plane, if I'm writing, in a plane, and the X, Y, Z coordinate, if the particle is lying in the X, Y, and Z coordinate part of relation, in a plane means we always take solo in X and Y. Z axis will become for me zero. And the XCM will become for me M1, X1 plus of your M2, X2 divided by M1 plus M2. Plane and YCM got on to the. So M1 into X1 into that is M1 into Y1 plus of your M2 into Y2 divided by M1 plus M2. What will be the ZCM? ZCM will be equal to zero because in the plane means it will be only X and Y.
Yes, sir. There is no third.
Okay, there is no third part. XCM is this one and this one is YCM. Whereas in space, if I'm talking about,
then we can get
then we can get in all the three coordinates, right?
Yes.
So in the third three in the space means what we will be getting? We'll be getting your XCM, we'll be getting your YCM, and we are getting your ZCM. That means that will be equal to your summation of your mith particle, xith particle divided by total mass, comma. This one will be summation of your mith particle, yith particle divided by your capital M. Same way for Z axis, if I'm taking summation of your mith particle, zith particle divided by capital M.
Yes, sir.
Like this M1, X1 plus M2, X2, M3, X3, M4, F4, like that infinite number of particles last into power together. So that is completely I'm taking in terms of your summation. And M1 plus M2, I'm taking it as of your capital M. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, check. See this one beta. If M1, comma, M2, comma, M3, so on are particles. Having position vector. Having position vectors. R1 bar, comma, R2 bar, comma, R3 bar, so on, etc. Then I can write R C O M position vector is equals to what I can write here M1 R1 bar plus of your M2 R2 bar plus of your M3 R3 bar plus so on up to your M N R N bar divided by this one is your total mass that is nothing but capital M. Right, sir?
Yes, sir.
M into RCM you take round of this one. So this one is the one particle in the position vector. So now it is capital M into RCM bar is equals to this one is M1 R1 plus of your M2 R2 plus of your M3 R3 bar plus so on up to your this one is your MN RN bar. Okay. Now differentiate this one with respect to time, beta. Isn't it? So differentiate with respect to time, we'll be getting velocity. That means m into RCM will be what, beta? Momentum, gada? Yes, so sir. Momentum of your center of mass will be equal to summation of your all the particles, pith particles. Antena?
Yes, sir.
One R1 means P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus yes, P4 sir. Plus P2PM. So PCM yes. will be equal to summation of your pith particle part affiliation. Now if I differentiate this one with respect to time, so DRCM by your DT, what will be get beta? DR by DT will give me what? Velocity. Okay. Yes, so what I can do is, differentiate with respect to time. And this one is M into, this one is of your DRCM divided by your DT is equals to M1 into, this one is DR1 divided by your DT plus of your M into D into your R2 divided by your DT plus one up to M into DRN particle divided by your DT. Okay, na?
Yes.
So this one is your M into DR by DT will give me what, beta? Velocity of center of mass. So that will be equal to your M1 into V1 plus of your M2 into V2 plus one up to your MN into your VN. Anagada. So we'll be getting right now velocity of center of mass will be equal to your M1 V1 plus of your M2 V2 plus so on up to your MN into VN bar divided by total mass. That is nothing but capital A. So this is the velocity of your center of mass of your N particles. Ante kada?
Yes, sir.
Now again, differentiate with respect to time now. Now, again, differentiate. Now again, differentiate with respect to time. With respect to time. So what will be getting right now? See, so this will become for me D into velocity of center of mass divided by your DT is equals to, this one is nothing but M1 into, this one is D into your V1 divided by DT plus of your M2 into D into your V2 divided by your DT plus one up to your MN into D into VN divided by your DT divided by total mass. Mass constant, because we can't differentiate this one. Okay, na? Now DVCM will become for me what, beta? ACM. Acceleration about your center of mass will be equal to your M1A1 plus of your M2A2 plus one up to your n number of particles MN into your AN divided by total mass. That is nothing but capital M. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
We got the velocity of center of mass for your x-axis. We got the velocity of for y-axis. We got the velocity for center of mass along z-axis in the space. Then position vector, center of mass. Then momentum of your center of mass. Then differentiating the position vector, we are getting what? Velocity of your center of mass and as well as of your acceleration of your center of mass part affiliation. Is that clear? Now, this point is something very, very important you need to remember, beta. This is actually a very important condition in the solving of numericals. Now, see, if I take this M here, this side, this will become for me M into your acceleration of your center of mass is equals to, this one is nothing but how much for me, beta? M1A1 plus of your M2A2 plus on up to your MN into your AN Rasko Chanana?
Yes.
M into your ACOM is nothing but what, beta? External force. F total yes, force will be equal to your F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus so on up to your Fn. Everything is a vector. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So it is your external forces and internal forces go on take other thing, isn't it? So I can write now the right now in the given condition, F external is equal to your force because of your external plus force because of your internal. Okay, summation. But force because of your internal is equal to zero. Why can you tell me? Because internal parts or internal particles will not have any effect. So that means there is no effect there is no effect of internal forces. There is no effect of your internal forces on your center of mass. Idi nu kachithanga gurtupettukovali. Internal force valla there is no effect on the center of mass. Okay, this will become for me zero. Ante F external will be equal to how much beta? F external will be equal to F external is equals to your M into your A into your C. Okay, na?
Yes.
So that is a given condition. If external force zero in anko, apde emi potundi cheppu. If external force zero annadu. If external force acting on the system,
sir, then there is no force.
That means acceleration of the center of mass will become how much? Zero. Acceleration of center of mass is equal to zero. That means it is conserved. Velocity of the body will be moving either with constant velocity or the system is at your rest position. The same way if I differentiate this one beta, d into your acceleration is nothing but of your velocity of your center of mass divided by your dt will be also equal to how much for me? Zero. Differentiation of this one zero and then velocity of center of mass and the constant velocity of center of mass will be equal to constant. When external force acting on the system is zero means acceleration is equals to zero. Acceleration is equals to zero. And velocity of center of mass will also be equal to zero. When
zero,
when external force acting
external
on the
force
system
is zero.
Zero. When external force acting on the system is equals to zero,
zero,
then acceleration of the center of mass is zero and velocity of your center of mass is also zero. Is that clear for everyone?
Yes.
So that is a very important relation you need to remember, Peter. External, because whenever we are taking the total system, this MACOM is nothing but because of external plus internal. But internal force valla, there is no effect on center of mass kabatti. There is no effect of your, there is no effect of your internal forces on your center of mass. So that is the reason internal force, I'm taking it as of your how much? Zero. So external force is only because of your total mass into acceleration of center of mass. If external force is zero, acceleration of center of mass is also zero, Peter. And velocity of center of mass will also become to
fully constant.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. How much time do we have, beta, for the recording?
8 minutes and 760.
Right, one question, beta. Find center of mass of the system. Find the center of mass of the system. Okay, I'll give the system somewhere here. So. Okay, here there is one particle, say for example, 1 kg. Here there is one particle, this one is of 2 kg and at the vertex there is another mass, this is of 3 kg. This is 1 meter, this is your 1 meter, this side is also 1 meter. So obviously what type of a triangle it is? Equilateral triangle. So this one is also 60, this one is also your 60. Okay, this one is perpendicular. Find the center of mass of the system, where the center of mass of the system will be lying. So, the center of mass is 1 kg and 2 kg somewhere at the center. So, total system center of mass will be lying at the centroid for the given condition. So, x-axis and the y-axis and the chaposar. So, what will be the value of your x-axis? X-axis will be equal to how much? The x. So, this x will be equal to cos into your 60. So, that will be equal to 1 by 2. The x.
Yes, yes.
1 meter. 1 meter no x axis lo resolve cheskunte that is equal to your 1 into cos 60. That is 1 by 2. The same way y. Y is equal to how much for me? 1 into your sine 60. Sine 60 is how much?
Root 3 by 2.
Isn't it? That means y axis. This one is y and this one is your x. So mass of your m1 is given how much for me? 1 kg. What are the coordinates of this one beta? X, comma y. That is x1, comma y1. Adhenta utun jabu? X1 0, Y1 goda 0. It is at origin.
Yes. Yes.
0, 0. The same way M2. M2 is equals to 2 kg. That means the coordinates are X2, comma, your Y2. X2 will be equal to how much beta? 1. and for this one y is 0 in the country the x2 is 1 meter from the x axis but it is not there on y axis kabatti y axis will become 0 in the same way m3 is equals to how much for me 3 kg coordinates for this one will be x3 comma y3 that will be equal to how much for me 1 by 2 idi kada idi y x axis will be equal to this much x axis ento vachindi 1 by 2 comma this is y axis y axis is how much for me root 3 by vachinda
yes
now xcom enta acceleration along the center of mass along x axis is equals to that is nothing but of your m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 into your x3 ona kada so first one is how much for me this one is m1 x1 plus of your m2 x2 plus of your em3 x3 divided by total mass that is nothing but m1 plus m2 plus m3 m1 ento undata m1 is equals to how many kgs 1 kgs into 0 plus next one is 2 x coordinate ento undi 1 plus next one is 3 x coordinate ento undi 1 by 2 divided by total mass is how much for me 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 3 6 so this will be the 6 and it ento avutundi 2 plus 3 1 3 by 2 antena
sir
ento avutundi 3 by 2 plus 2
7 by 2 7 by 2 will come 7 by 12
by 6 ante this will become for me 7 by
7 by 12
vachinda
yes sir
in the same way ycm so velocity along your center of mass will be equal to your m1 y1 plus of m2 y2 plus of your m3 y3 divided by your m1 plus of your m1 plus m2 plus of your m3 m1 is how much 1 y1 is how much 0 plus m2 is how much 2 y2 is how much 0 antena chudu y2 is 0 y1 0 y2 0 y3 root 3 by 2 ante this one will be equal to 3 into your root 3 by 2 divided by your 6 ardhamainda ante this will become for me 6
root
3
by 2
ante kada so this is 3 1 sir 3 2 sir so this will be root 3 by 4 root 3 by 4 antena
Yes,
that means x coordinate comma xcom comma this I'll take here right now xcom comma ycom will be equal to how much wait answer 7 by 12 comma this will be equal to how much for me root 3 by 4 okay na
yes sir.
So this is your answer for this one. Coordinates of the center of mass along x axis and y axis is it clear
yes sir.
Isn't it? Okay. Adhamainda manasu cheppana.
Okay sir. Kochu.
Inga time undu naa daggara.
Inka 2 minutes.
Okay, then I'll stop and restart it na.
Okay.